Hey everyone, this is Tony Teaches Tech. I'm Tony, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to fix the remote host identification has changed warning that you might be experiencing right now, and do my best to explain why this is happening. So let's go ahead and take a look at the tutorial here. As you can see here, I know this is just like a bunch of text, but I did log into a server at this IP address as root. It was the first time logging in, so I got the typical, the authenticity of the host can't be established, blah, blah, blah. Yes, I agree. I'm going to continue connecting. And then I logged in to this operating system, which was Debian. I logged out. And after I logged out, I re-imaged the server. Okay, I completely wiped Debian off of it and created a whole new Debian operating system image on it. And doing that will cause me to see that remote host identification has changed warning. So that's my prediction, what we're gonna see here when we try to SSH in again. So let's do that. SSH root at that same IP address, same thing up here, hit enter. And we obviously see that error warning remote host identification has changed because I re-imaged that server. Now that's not the only time you'll see that type of error warning show up, but that's one of them. How do we get around it? How do we log into our server and get around this warning? So there are a couple different ways, one quick and easy way and one way that I recommend. Let me show you the quick and easy way first. And if you kind of read through here, specifically at this line, the offending key is in your SSH directory, known hosts at line 201. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. I'm going to use the Vim text editor, open up the SSH directory, a file in there called known hosts. If I go down to line 201, we will see that IP address and the associated key with that. So that key was issued as a known host when I initially connected to it. But that key has since changed. Now what I can do is simply get rid of this line and proceed to log in via SSH, and that will work. That's the quick and easy way. But let's not do that. Let's do the more sophisticated way. So instead of doing that, let's instead type in ssh-keygen dash R, capital R, and then the IP address, okay? And what this is gonna do is update our known host file, kind of just like exactly what we just did. It's gonna get rid of that line in that known host file, but it's also gonna back up the contents of the file in your known host.old, just in case, for whatever reason, you need to go back and use that old information. So now, if we go ahead and try to SSH into that same IP address, we should get past that. And again, this is a new Debian image, so we get that initial warning about, are you sure you want to continue connecting? Yes. And now we are logged into that. Oops, I have to type in the password. And now we are logged into that remote server, bypassing that remote host identification exchange warning. Guys, if you have any questions about this, let me know in the comments below. I'll do my best to help you out. Check out some of my other Ubuntu, Debian, Linux videos over here. And if you do, I'll see you in the next video.